and that kind of braking system is called self-locking brake. Hello friends, so today in this video we are going to talk about single block or shoe brake. Okay, so first of all let's see the different types of brake. Okay, so hydraulic brake is one of the first type. Second type is electric brake, and third is mechanical brakes. So mechanical brakes are further classified into two parts: radial brakes and axle brakes. Okay, so single block or shoe brake is a type of radial brakes. So we'll discuss about the radial brakes only because they are widely used in bikes and different vehicles. So first of all let's see what is the definition for radial brakes. So radial brakes, in these brakes the force acting on the brake drum is in the radial direction, means it is in the direction of the radius. So that's why it is called the radial brakes. Okay, and the second one is axial. So here the force is acting along the axis, so that's why it is called the axial brakes. Now let us see what is single block or shoe brake. So first of all let's see its diagram. So it is a fulcrum fixed point. Okay, and here it is pivoted by a this is a lever upon which a force P is applied. So let us first of all let's see the theory and as well as see the diagram. Okay, so this is the theory. When we apply P force on the lever, then the friction is generated in between the block and wheel. So here first of all let's see what is brake and what is block and what is wheel. So this one is a block and this one is a wheel. So when the force P is applied over here, then what happens that this is fixed point. So what happens that it moves down, and due to that reason this block get attached with the wheel or rim. Okay, so that's why friction is generated. Now here this is the x distance in between the normal reaction and the fixed point, and x and l is the length of the lever. Okay, now further see what happens that when then the friction is generated between the block and the wheel. Now what happens, the friction is generated due to which a tangential braking force is acting on the wheel. So this is the tangential force Ft which is acting along this direction. Okay, now which retards the or slows down the rotation of the wheel, means it is slowing down the rotation of the wheel. It is usual that when we apply force on it, then what happens that there is friction generated in between this surface and this surface, and that will generate the retardation. That's why the vehicle stops. Now in this case vehicle is rotated in anti-clockwise direction, means the wheels are rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Then what happens when we apply a force when we apply force P on this surface, then what happens that due to that reaction Rn is developed. Okay, and this is the Ft force that is due to the friction. Okay, this is the tangential force that is generated. Now by using this we could write down the moment equation. So moment about this fulcrum is taken, that would be equal to zero. So here it is the distance in between the tangential force applied and the axis. Okay, so that would be equal to, this is in clockwise direction, so that would be plus Ft into A. Okay, and then again this Rn is in negative direction, means Rn into this distance x negative direction, and again P is in clockwise direction. Okay, so from this point this is in positive direction, means plus PL, that would be equal to zero. This is the moment equation that we could write over here. Okay, now we know that Ft is equal to mu into Rn, or F means the friction, F force equal to mu n. So from that equation we could obtain this, and we know that torque is F tangential force into radius. So we got the value of Ft, and then we could find out the value of TB, means braking torque. Okay, so the final motive is to find out the braking torque. Now after solving this we could find out the value of Rn. Okay, this is the equation that I have solved. Okay, just simply what you need to do, you need to just simply put the value of Ft and then simplify it. After simplifying you could get the value of TB as this. Now there is one thing to note, that if the angle of contact is less than 60 degree, then only this braking system could be applied. Okay, only in that case this braking system could be applied, unless we need to use pivoted or double block braking system. Okay, so we will see in next lectures. Now let us discuss about the note 2, that is block is made up of softer material, means the block should be softer than the rim, because if the block would be made of the harder material, then what will happen, it will be easily wear and tear, wheel will get wear and tear, then that would damage the wheel, so it should not happen. Here I have wrote down some terms. P is the force applied at the end of the lever. Okay, as per the diagram, here it is the diagram. Okay, as per the diagram everything is written. R is normal force. Okay, R is the radius of the wheel, theta, 2 theta is the angle of contact of surface of the block. Okay, so if you are not getting this, then what is this? This is the block. Okay, and this is the angle in between the wheel and the block. Okay, surface and the block. Now mu is coefficient friction and Ft is the tangential force. Now this is one assumption that we have taken, and the assumption is normal pressure between the block and the wheel is uniform, means the pressure in between the block and the wheel should be uniform. There should not be any change or variation in between these surfaces in pressure. Now here comes the important part, kindly watch this carefully. Okay, so now what is happening here, we have solved this equation. Okay, already we have got this over here. Okay, so this one is moment of friction force mu Rn into A, that is the distance. Okay, A is this distance, and here this PL is due to the moment of force. Okay, so what happened, those brakes in which frictional force helps to apply the brake are called self-energizing brakes. Okay, means such brakes in which we are getting this amount of force, extra force, are called the self-energizing brakes. Okay, and from the above expression we can see that if x is less than mu a, then what will happen, p would get negative, automatically it will be negative. If this will this value would be negative, then what will happen, this value will also get negative, and due to that reason p will be negative, and means if pressure is negative, then what is happening, there is no pressure or equal to zero, so means no external force is required to apply brakes, means automatically the vehicle will be at rest if we will use this system. Okay, when x is less than mu a, then automatically vehicle will be at rest, and that kind of braking system is called self-locking brake. Okay, so what is the conclusion? The conclusion is that brake should self-energizing, not self-locking. Okay, and to avoid self-locking we need to apply this condition, x should be greater than mu a. So that's all, thank you for watching. If you want to subscribe, then click here, and that's all. For more stuff click here.